Secret Society.
Quab Squad, baby.
Bonafide. Getting money, build a recipe.
It's your boy John Harrowalu. We're chilling today on the Couch Trap Life TV, that is, and we'll be the man Carlos. Omi, what's good, man? The producer.
Good.
Yeah.
Feels good to be back home.
Mm-hmm.
Feels good to be back here.
Right.
This is where we started at. You know what I'm saying? Me and this man right here, we go way back, right?
No doubt, man.
Like Superman draws. like Batman underpants. Me, my dude, Bonafide, we go way back. So it feels good be back here where we started at, you know. So it's a pleasure, bro. It's a pleasure.
It is though, man. Yeah. It is though. My pleasure's all mine.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what, man? It's about to be an exciting episode. We with the producer today. We're gonna switch it up on all you. We're gonna ask a bit more questions. We're gonna get in depth in the nook and crannies, man.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna get all that knowledge out, man, and you know, just have a good time and enjoy ourselves, man. Let's get straight into it, man. Carlos.
Yo,
tell them what's up, man.
Yo, I don't know, bro. I'm just chilling right now, man.
Right.
I'm just enjoying my little cloud.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Right.
I'm really working hard. Too hard. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, I had to come through back here.
Right.
Show love to the homies. You know, just catch up. Right. Shoot the proverbial shit. You know? Just do us. But right now, I'm on break. I've just had a whole bunch of projects dropping left, right, and center.
Back to back.
Bruh. I don't know how many EPs I've just dropped. I'm not calling myself the king of EPs. You know, but the word is just falling around. But I've just been working really hard, bro.
I respect to that, man.
Yeah, true.
Respect to that, man.
And yo, I've seen your little video hustle too. My man cutting video. And you legit with that.
Yo, man, we gotta try, man.
You know what I'm saying?
You gotta work hard.
This, that. You know what I mean? He really good with that. Sir John Henry, bro.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, man. Anytime, bro.
Yo, but let's get back to you, man. Right. You the man, you with us today, man. Tell us what it's like, man. Producer. We ain't seen that. We ain't spoken about that side of music in a while.
I know. Yeah. It's been a minute.
Hit us up, man. Hit us up with some knowledge, man. What's it been like for you? What's the experience?
Man, it's been crazy. But funny thing is, this has always been my childhood dream.
Mm-hmm.
You get me?
Right.
A lot of cats, they always always want to be the motherfucking pilot or some shit like that. Which is, there's nothing wrong with that and shit like that.
Sorry.
I know. But for me, I've always wanted to just be an artist, a music producer specifically.
Right.
So, to be honest, I'm living my dream right now, bro. So, I can't really complain. Mm. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm living my dream. Says in blame at all.
Yo, man. That's the best. That's the best of the world right now.
Yeah, true, man.
Yeah. And I heard your shit, man. Yeah? It shows. The passion shows in the craft, man.
I know, bro.
We're going to get all into that, right?
I know, bro. Come on, bro. I've been doing this since 2007.
God damn, yo. Big numbers, man.
I know, bro. If I had a kid
right
in 2007, they'd be a teenager right now. Just respect the OGs. Respect the OGs, bro. Yeah, that's all I gotta say, bro.
No doubt, man.
Yeah.
So hit us up, man. You've been in the game.
Yeah.
207, those are big numbers, by the way. Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell us what you've seen change in the game over time, man. You know, from the vixen side, from the rapper side, you know, from the genre side.
Mm.
What's up with that, man? What's been your take on the, especially, let's go local, man. Yeah, let's go Kenya.
Yeah.
What's been your take of the Kenyan music industry? All the music.
All I can say, as far as our game goes, we've come from far. We've come from really far. Because I remember when we used to go for studio sessions, it used to cost us close to 50 G's to record one song. You feel me?
And that was back in the day?
Yeah, and that was 2007, 2008 there, so it was really crazy. But with the advent
mm-hmm.
of like technology, mm-hmm. especially within the realm of music production and stuff like that.
Right.
I can say it's kind of like compartmentalized,
mm-hmm.
like the whole process of getting like your record out and stuff like that. Because right now, all you need is like a laptop and a mic, bro.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And
you're good.
Crazy the times we are.
Right? I know. Because kitambo ilikuwa yo, bro, kuna hii mixa bigi. 33 channel up and you fucking up. You know what I mean? But right now, yeah, stuff may change. And also play like ningependa ku big up. I mean, this is weird, but like the Genge Tone artists,
mm-hmm.
they've really pushed like local music back to where it was supposed to be ever since back in the day.
Right, right.
If you remember?
Because
back in the day, like local music was huge, bro.
Mm-hmm.
There was the Isas, the Noninis, you know,
Klepto,
all them cats. And then somehow, like along the way, like Mikatuli Potengia started bumping that Niger shit. Shout out to all our West African brethren.
Yeah.
Fuck with your heavy. But you know, this is our home, so we gotta represent us. So yeah, so the Genge Tone artists, like, they've really brought that like feeling back. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Obviously your content yuko like kitoko kuna ndevu, but still I can
gotta
say
give
like
props,
yo, gotta give Caesar his due, bro.
We always
have to give Caesar his due.
Mm-hmm.
But all I can say is like with the advent of new technology,
mm-hmm.
it's made the industry grow bigger,
mm.
in terms of now anybody can just like record. In terms of if you're artistic and you want to get like your music out there, you can just do that, as well as like social media.
Mm.
Yeah, and that's really helped out.
Yeah, no doubt, man.
Yeah,
and it's crazy that I actually mentioned that, because I was just thinking the other day, like, it had been a while before you could hear like Kenyan music even in our mats, you know?
True.
You'd be on the mats, there was like a session where it was bongo.
Yeah.
Then it was the West African shit.
Yeah, true.
Then it started getting back to Kenya, but it was still some of the, you know, just a tap of the gospel shit.
True.
But of late, man, you go in a mat, it's full, the whole ride,
I
man.
I know, bro.
You know, Ronga to Nairobi, Robbie, it's the same music. Yeah?
And it's because of these kids, it's because of these Genge Tone kids, because, bro, I'm like 30 years old, bro. Like, I'm really old. Not like really, really old, but nime piga lap yangu, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, kunanga ato hii, waki dure iteng.
Because
I remember when we were doing trap,
right?
Like, OGs were really stepping on our neck, especially me and Bonafide, bro.
Mm.
They were like, yo, what the fuck you niggas doing? Yeah, it's a if I can't. About to not have a kelele. And look at us now, bro. I'm getting $700 just from sending a beat back to some white kid in Poland. You know what I mean?
So
I'm just saying, like times have changed, and I have to give my props to like the young cats right now, because they're really pushing the agenda.
Mm.
For us, it was a bit different for guys from my generation, because like, no disrespect, we tend to be a bit pussy.
Mm-hmm.
No disrespect to the women, you know, still like love yours, because it's a pussy, it doesn't mean I'm like, you know, sexist or some shit like that. But during our time, like, uluko unaogopeshwa, you know, like, wait, unajua mimi nani? Fanya hivyo utajitango mako hapa. So, kawe gearbox, bro, kupabaya.
Yeah.
So, now it's changed, because these kids, bro, like in this hood alone, in Donholm, Greeny, bro, kuna mastudio ka sita. Mine included. Right? Like, that's a lot of creative talent just going around, man.
Yeah.
And ata kwanza on that note, big up, like, Kina Vuva Manze 34 gang, big up Kid Chronic, bro. That's my like little bro right there, bro.
You're nice with it.
Yeah,
you're
man.
Nice with it.
A dope producer and a dope songwriter. Mm. Big up to SK Silent Killer. He just dropped a new tape, bro, and he's doing his thing. Alright, and I'm proud of that.
Right.
And you can't do that if we do not have studios like where we can just get our creative juices out there.
Right.
So during that span of me starting and now, a lot of studios have sprung up, again because of the advent of new technology, and also because this new kids generation, the new generation, Generation Z, they're not afraid of getting their music out there.
Yeah, they're confident.
Yeah, you know.
Willing to try anything.
Yeah. Because for us, we were like really scared. Kama ukoneza kufanya mziki kama haiko ya so and so au kuneza kuchezo. You know, but
yeah, radio play was, radio play
but,
was hard.
Yeah, but say to you are like, man, we don't give a fuck about no radio, bro. Yeah,
we throwing that shit on YouTube.
Yeah, bro, that's what I skier. You know, you know, on YouTube on streaming platforms and guys are going there and supporting it, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So I can't really say that, you know, joining sahi to ko at to ko papoa vile, but we are way better off than we were like
before.
Yeah, 13 years ago.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, time comes with some improvements.
Yeah? Exactly, bro. True, true. Yeah.
So, let's go a bit deeper into it, man.
Yeah.
We've spoken a lot about the OGs, you know, the guys who are early in the game.
Yeah.
What do you see now about where they are, man? Since you have grown with them, about what do you see about how can we say how they've moved through the ages? You know, maybe some of them have moved up from, you know, the whole music game into other things, you know.
Yeah.
Some of the ladies in the game are now moms, man. Yeah.
Oh my God. What do you think about that, man? Oh my God, bruh.
yo. Sounds like you're about to drop some heat.
You know what's funny?
Yeah.
I'm not gonna mention any names, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But there's this video fixing, like when I was in from four.
Yeah.
Around like 2007, 2008, right? She was really popping off, right? Zilikuwa zilema videos za back in the days, a Bumba, nini, Mzuri, all that shit.
Right?
And right now, like I was like just doing my little shopping the other day at the mall and shit.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, yo, she look like so and so, bro. Because I remember back in the day, like nikipiga my laps, like during mukenda kwa video shoot, zo artists, to kitu get your name out there, uliko unapatana nao. So now I check in, like, oh, bruh, like she's like my sister's age, bro. She's like 40, bro.
Right.
And I'm like, yo, she got a young dude. I'm like, yo, man, she must like young me. You know what I mean? So I'm like, yo, I'm not trying to judge. I'm not trying to judge. So I'm like, yo, do your thing. Mm-hmm. But I was like, yo, I'm a nosy motherfucker. So I just had to be like, hey, what's up, girl? Like, yada. I'm like, yeah. So I'm like, yo, who's this? Like, yo, that's my son. I'm like, what? Yeah,
what?
Bruh, like, and this is a whole ass nigga, bro.
No way.
Like, bruh, you know, a whole ass man. I'm like, bruh, how old is you? Like, 17. Oh! 17, bro. and this hoe used to twerk in like no Nini videos, bro. I'm like, yo, I'm going like in Mr. Lenny videos, in Kunguru videos. I'm like, yo, bro. Hey, yo, you got a whole ass kid. Yo, no disrespect. I got a kid too, you know what I'm saying? But
damn.
He ain't a whole ass nigga though.
Yo, 17?
Yeah, bro. But
give that man an ID, man.
I know, bro.
That's a dude.
But it's crazy. But it's crazy just how like time, you know, for the goofy like when you mess up, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you're like, oh, I got to like a shock to the system. I was like, yo, who the fuck am I to judge? I got a kid too, bro. Yeah. Damn. Hey, 17, no. Yeah, man.
Wow.
But big ups to her, bro, because she still pushed like the industry forward. Because it was like during those back in the day moments, this was like in a toxic and shit.
Mm.
You remember those days, V? Like it was like Ando Lukwa got the first like video vixens like in a toxic.
Do it, man.
Yeah, bro. Yeah.
With
man.
The synchronized dance
moves. Yeah, exactly. That stuff. Okay, there wasn't no synchronized dance moves and shit like that. Back in a toxic, nice the Boomba girls, all those chicks, bro.
Mm-hmm.
They were like legit, bro. They were like legit. We're 35. Getting money made a recipe. We're 35. Make your boss move song. We're 35.
Go.